Hey, what is up, and welcome to I'll Take a Shot at That, the podcast for thinkers, wanderers, and drinking ponderers. I am, of course, your host, Matthew Hendershot, and I got a really fun episode for you this week. I'm currently in New York City on a work/vacation trip, so it wasn't really easy for me to sit down and get an episode done. So for this episode, I want you to sit back and enjoy a crossover publication of an episode of the Intruder Green podcast that I was the guest on as we rolled into 2020. Don't forget, you can find all the past episodes and all the links to our social media, everything like that. Support the show. All you got to do is go to one place, shotatthat.com, to find everything you need. And otherwise, check out intrudergreen.com to like and subscribe to his podcast, and sit back and enjoy as we roll into the new year with Intruder Green.
Hi, I'm Intruder Green. You might know me from things like I'll Take a Shot at That podcast, Cold It's Castle, and Twitch. Welcome to the Intruder Green podcast. Happy New Year, everybody. Gotta say that for starters. I think we're still saying that. I mean, I realize it's like the end of January when I'm finally getting this out, and I apologize for all of that. I'm sure I'm gonna talk about it in the podcast. At least I think it did. Anyway, you know, everybody kind of takes a break for the holidays, and that's real hard and everything. So, yeah, you know, like I gotta do that too. Plus, you know, I changed hideouts a little bit, so I'm in a different spot, and that took some, you know, timing and planning and work to do. But anyway, we're finally getting an episode out. It's the first one of the new year and the new millennium. Not in the new millennium. That's way too far away. Shit. It's the new decade. So that's real good. I just did a little recap with my buddy Matthew. He's my caterer, and he helps me with a lot of tech stuff. And he's going to help me start making this podcast sound real good. As you will probably hear, we talk about that. And also, spoiler alert or whatever, I'm going to be a regular on the I'll Take a Shot at That podcast from now on. So you can go check that out if you aren't already subscribed. Go check out I'll Take a Shot at That. It's kind of about like life in Germany and stuff. And it's also a drinking podcast, so you can like play drinking games when you're listening to it. I think you could probably play drinking games with like any kind of podcast, really. Like even this one, like maybe every time I say yeah or something like that, that'd be real good. Tell me if you guys do anything like that, and I will be stoked to know it. Want to give a shout out to my producers, Luke Ellis, Elizabeth Bernards, Heather Royston, John Nicholas, James Michael Lamar, Irving Edward, Donald Calvin, McGolderin, Vaughn Cotton, Christy Antihero, Chelsea McNally, Carlos Hernandez, Sarah Koenig, Gem City Sabrina, and Cardboard Box Colony. Thanks you guys for sticking in there, even though we've kind of, you know, basically taking a month off here. I've worked on some shit, and some things due to technical difficulties fell through. I'm going to try and recap that. I'll try to get another one out before the month is over, because I like to do a minimum of two episodes, you know, for you guys. And trying to do more, though. I would like to do this once a week, but, you know, you guys, I got to get people hitting me up on the DMs and stuff. Like, you know, the bomb pops, they always doing that sliding. Oh, there's some noise. That's real nice happening right now. You hear that? I'm sure you can. It's fucking good and loud. There's fucking jailbreak or something going on next door. Anyway, I got, yeah. Hit me up on the DMs or like however you guys want to do it. The Intruder Green call-in line is +1-608-535-9608. Patreon.com/IntruderGreen if you want to become a producer. Matthew's also having me do some Twitch stuff. I think I talk about that. I'll let you guys get on with the episode here. Without further ado, it's me and Matthew Hendershot on the Intruder Green podcast. On with the show.
Hello, this is a prepaid collect call from
Intruder Green,
an inmate at Mineral Correctional Institution. This call is subject to recording and monitoring. To accept charges, press 1.
To a place where nobody goes. Ladies and gentlemen, Matthew Hendershot on the Intruder Green podcast. All right.
I'm that guy.
That's right. From I'll Take a Shot at That fame, as well as many other things.
Lack of fame.
Yeah. We're getting there.
Yeah.
Did some twitching. Is that what it's called? Twitching when you're on Twitch and you do stuff?
Well, you were definitely twitching.
Yeah, but you got to help me with that because I don't know what the fuck I'm doing with that.
I think they make medications. Stuff.
They make, yeah.
To stop That's you from right. twitching.
My eye is always twitching. Turns out, you know, has to do with dehydration and stress and stuff.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, I think. I mean, I'm just assuming. Seems like everything, if there's something wrong with your body, they're like, oh, you should not be so stressed out and probably drink more water.
Drink
you know?
More water.
Yeah, that's like the solution to everything. It seems like it. I don't know. I'm not trying to solve no problems here myself. Hey, is that doing anything? It looks like one of them is just doing nothing. Is that working?
Yeah, that's working. That's me on top.
Oh, shit. I'm doing all the blabbing. All right. So, yeah, new technology. That's one of the things I wanted to bring up. And let me preface this by saying one of the reasons I wanted to do like another podcast with you is because A, you're available, and B, I don't do like New Year's resolutions and stuff.
Okay.
I guess we were going to talk about that later on the Shot at That podcast.
Yeah, we might.
But
we might get into that.
A spoiler alert. I'm going to do one of them here. I got plenty more.
Sure.
Even though I said I don't do them just now. But yeah. I did them. I thought about it because when we talked about doing it, I was like, maybe I should do some. Because it's going to be real boring if I don't have anything to talk about otherwise. One of the things I want to do is no more like shitty sounding podcasts on the Intruder Green podcast. I struggled with some of the quality, the auto asphyxiation. No, that's the different thing.
That's a different thing.
Audio quality. That's the one. You get
audio fixated? Is that what you're trying
audio
to say?
Audio fixated. I get fixated on trying to make good audio quality, and somehow I still end up not doing very good on it. But, yeah, that's the thing for me is, like, you know, sometimes when you're doing stuff, you're out in the field or something, like, you want to go do a remote recording.
Mm-hmm.
There's going to be background noise and stuff that you just can't help, but that can sound kind of cool sometimes.
Yeah.
Or sometimes you're trying to do like a phone interview and you don't know exactly how to go about it. So you think, well, I'll just put my phone up to the microphone and then they can hear that and it'll sound fine.
I don't think
it
sounds fine.
And then you do a whole fucking hour long interview and then you go back and listen to it and you're like, holy shit, there's no way I can possibly release this on my fucking podcast. It sounds like absolute garbage and there's no fucking amount of Adobe-ing I could do to make it sound better.
Yeah, phone interviews are the worst.
I mean, they can sound okay if you got like a decent, you know, like, but a decent phone signal or like at least a phone signal. But like when you got it coming out of a speaker going into a microphone that's also not very good.
Yeah.
It just does not sound good.
Yeah.
This happened to me. They
fuck you over with like the technology too, right? Because you can't even get like a microphone splitter because it's like a three-way cable, right? Because you have to have the microphone going in and your headphones.
I think they sell them. I saw a thing on YouTube once about it.
How is it possible that like in the DDR times, it was easier to tap a phone than it is now?
Yeah, right? I mean, yeah, it's weird because like you got all these... you know, there's all these apps for like recording your phone calls and stuff.
Are there?
Yo, yeah, there's a bunch of them if you just like look it up. I don't know, what you got like an iPhone or something?
I don't, no.
Well, good. But neither do I. But, you know, you go into like the Google Play Store or whatever you got, and there's some stuff in there.
To record your phone call.
But to record a phone call, but then like...
But it's on your side of the call?
No, I think it does the whole thing. I haven't actually used it yet, though, because the thing is... Nobody I ever talked to ever wants to fucking talk on a regular phone. They're always like, oh, you got WhatsApp? Or like, you fucking... I'm always trying to get them to use Skype because I'm like, oh, yeah, Skype sounds good for podcasting purposes.
Yeah, or like Google Hangouts or something.
Yeah, and everybody's like, I don't know anything about that. What, you got this other app? And I'm like, I mean, I can get it, and I want to be like... what's the word? Not compromising, but like I want to compromise myself,
right?
To for the purpose, like making them, you know, more able to do it.
Can't you make WhatsApp phone calls from the internet now, though? Like from a computer?
From a maybe? I don't know. I never tried that.
I've never tried it either.
But regardless, I don't know. It don't record too good.
Mm.
And then, you know, you got your regular audio recorder on your phone. It's all this technology shit I'm trying to figure out.
Yeah, it's a lot.
And I fucked myself, Matthew.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, because I was going to do this fucking podcast with my buddy Rob. He does a bunch of charity stuff, and he's doing a new one with this thing called Punk Rock Saves Lives. And we had a real good conversation, and yeah, and I can't fucking release it. I just can't. It's just too garbage sounding. Like, he did a great job. I did, you know, my normal job, which is not great, but good enough, I guess. Hmm. And the thing is, it just sounds so shitty that I can't put it out there. So, yeah, I didn't want to start, especially, like, to start out 2020. I want to be like, hey, everybody, it's the Intruder Green Podcast. Doesn't it sound like shit? Hope you're ready for more of this for a full fucking year.
A whole year of
yeah. That would have been a way to go.
Oh, sorry, man.
It's okay. I'm not going to bum out about it too much. I just hope everybody understands that sometimes shit happens, and then that's why it takes a little longer to come out with episodes and stuff like that. Plus, yeah, I don't know. This whole month has been fucking weird for me. I feel like I shouldn't be as busy as I am, and I got all this stuff to do.
Yeah, I think that's pretty common at the beginning of the year for a lot of people, right? Because you want to do everything in the new year, especially, like, come on, it's 2020. It's a new decade.
That's right.
The Roaring Twenties are back.
That's right.
Right?
Fucking, I heard on the internet that we got, like, the greatest economy of all time in America.
That's good. Maybe we can end in a Great Depression like the original 1920s. Hey, like the 1920s? You want to do that?
I think most Americans are already pretty depressed, so.
I like how people are super excited. They think it's going to be all fucking Jay Gatsby, like, for the next decade. And all right. Forget the fact that the actual Roaring Twenties ended in the Great Depression.
Right.
And then led us into a world war.
But that guy liked the party, so that's cool.
Yeah.
As long as we could party, I mean.
Party till whatever. The lights go out.
I think
out.
That's the option. I think that's like what the people in America just want to do now. They're like, man, shit's so fucked. Let's just go to the bar.
Let's just go to the bar?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or this Great Gatsby guy's house, and he's always throwing parties. Turns out he's been dead for decades, but they still party at his house. Yeah, that sounds good.
Do they?
I don't know.
That could be cool.
That could be cool. It was a good house. I seen that movie.
I don't think I ever saw the movie.
I saw the movie. It wasn't great, but, you know, everybody loves Leonardo DiCaprio. I'm not sure why.
Except the Academy Awards Academy.
Oh, yeah. He had to fight hard to get one.
I think he had to get raped by a bear, didn't he?
That's true. That's pretty much what happened. Did that movie come out last year or the year before?
2 years ago, I think.
Yeah, that fucking...
The Revenant?
The Revenant. That was a good-ass movie.
Yeah.
Did you see it in a theater?
I did not.
Oh, I think that's one of those movies you got to see in a theater because there's so much, like, beautiful landscapes and shit.
Yeah, it was really pretty.
Yeah.
There was a bunch of stories about how, like, a lot of the crew quit and stuff because they made them go... They shot it in, like, Peru?
Yeah.
Or in Argentina, like in South America. But it was the only place that they could go where there would be snow like that.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
When they did it. So they went high into the Andes mountains.
Oh, yeah, because it's like, yeah, sure.
Like, can you imagine trekking through all that shit? Like, they actually went to those locations. It was cold as fuck, snow everywhere.
And
you're out there all day.
Based on that.
Well, and like,
jeepers,
they were.
It must be nice.
Climb the Andes mountains, right? And with like camera equipment and stuff and get stranded out there trying to make this film. And I think everybody, like, or the first group of people they hired, like, peaced out on them.
Yeah, I don't know. Sounds like a fun adventure to me. And they got paid for it, so.
Well, might not have been enough.
Yeah, I'm sure. Yeah, I don't know.
I don't know either.
I got issues with that. But anyway.
Not getting paid enough? Or getting paid in general?
Getting paid in general, I guess. I mean, I guess maybe they're like big professionals and they're like, oh, I could go back to Hollywood and, you know, do something on a soundstage and make like 3 times as much.
Probably.
Yeah. Probably. I guess, okay, when you put it that way, I'm like, fine, but fuck it, I'll fucking climb the Andes Mountain and fucking run, fucking point a camera at Leonardo DiCaprio. All right. He's good looking, too, you know? You know, we'll hang out, fucking snowball fights and shit.
Maybe you get some of the fall off from the ladies that he rejects.
That's right.
Because isn't he still like one of the most eligible bachelors in Hollywood?
Oh my goodness. Probably. I don't know. I guess I never heard that he got married or nothing.
I guess if you wingmanned for Leonardo DiCaprio, you're probably going to do all right.
Yeah. That's a hell of a wingman move. I mean, he's got a... Yeah, you probably have to like... That's a sought after position in itself, you know?
Probably like a multiple interview application process.
That's right. I mean,
background checks.
We got, I just saw that movie Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, and he had Brad Pitt as his wingman. I mean, that's fucked up. Yeah. I always figured it'd be the other way around, personally. I think Brad Pitt's also very handsome, and he's in good movies.
Yeah.
But then again, I don't know. That movie was pretty good. But yeah, wingmen. I don't know. Who knows? Movies are tight though.
You excited about any upcoming movies in 2020?
I don't know. I mean, as some people know, I'm a big fan of the Marvel movies. I even did a thing on that a little while back, and I guess I'm excited for them. But I feel like,
what do they got going on now? Like, what's the next?
They announced a bunch of shit at the end of, like...
Because it's like the new phase, right? Because we just had the whole Infinity War thing come to a close.
And I don't know how the fuck they're going to top that. But, you know, they did a Spider-Man movie after that. And that was cool because they got this way of doing it. And it's funny because it's a lot like... They're basically doing the same way they did the comic books, but in movie form.
Right.
And I think... It's kind of like DC's doing it too, except, I don't know, they keep finding ways to shoot themselves in the foot.
They have the worst directors on the planet.
Yeah, but it's also kind of like what they're doing to like...
We'll see what happens.
To create a thing, because it's like, okay, the Joker movie, you seen that?
The new one.
Yeah.
The Joaquin Phoenix one.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's really good.
That fucking movie's great.
But that's not really a comic book movie.
Well, I don't know. Probably not, but...
They did weave in there like some Batman stuff, sure.
Right. It definitely takes place in like the DCEU or whatever they call it. And
but that's a completely different Joker than like...
Yeah, but then what though?
Like Heath Ledger Joker.
Right.
There was no Joker.
But that's not part of the whole universe that they're trying to build.
Right.
So it makes sense in a way if that might be like the Joker in that universe. But the thing is,
unfortunately though, I think that the Joker in that universe, because if you're trying to like anchor it all together, right?
Yeah.
And the only thing that ties in Justice League, right? Or even like Batman versus Superman, which is the prequel to Justice League, is that right? And Wonder Woman and everything like that.
Because they called it Dawn of Justice.
Dawn of Justice. Show
up just fucking out of nowhere or something.
So, but the only thing that ties any Joker at all to that is Batman as Ben Affleck, Batfleck.
Yeah.
And so if you're taking that route, then the only Joker that exists right now in the DC movie universe is Jared Leto from Suicide Squad, because Ben Affleck was in Suicide Squad.
Oh, as Batman?
As Batman.
Oh, shit. I didn't know that.
So you have that Joker and Harley Quinn and the Suicide Squad in the DC universe.
I got faith in the Suicide Squad, too. Okay, we're talking about new movies this year. I've been very disappointed with a lot of DC stuff.
Yeah.
Joker was good. The Christopher Nolan Batman movies were pretty good.
They were really good.
They were really good. The third one was kind of like...
It was a lot. They were trying to pack in a lot.
That's true.
Into one film. It was pretty ambitious.
But yeah, but the thing is, when they're trying to like do the Marvel thing, and they're trying to like build this universe where all these characters coexist together, it just doesn't work the same way. Because, and I think it's because a lot of the way DC was made up when they were creating these characters was they always kind of like worked on their own. And yeah, of course they did have the Justice League and everything eventually, but Marvel was kind of based around these characters like having crossovers
teams.
And stuff on it. Teams, yeah, stuff like that. Like on a regular basis. And they just do it better. I don't know. I don't know. It's like DC is good at one thing, and it's creating these like dark fucking brutal kind of movies, like the Christopher Nolan and the new Joker movie is so fucking good.
And the TV shows, honestly.
TV shows, like which DC, ones? Like the old 60s Batman?
No, like Titans? Did you see any of Titans?
No.
Titans was pretty good.
Yeah.
Or, they're getting ready to have there's going to be the new, Harley Quinn Birds of Prey movie.
Yeah, seen.
Which does not look great.
Yeah, doesn't look good. Looks like just another.
More Suicide Squad
exactly.
stuff.
Exactly.
Which wasn't, I didn't think, very good either.
No, I There's thought it was... going to
be another Suicide Squad.
Barely a movie.
Also not going to be great.
Well, I don't know about that because they got James Gunn to direct it.
Right.
And write it. So I have a little bit of faith there because...
Guardians was
frankly,
great.
Frankly, that guy is my favorite director. Like, I don't know that he's done anything I don't like.
Mm. I mean, he did some things that I don't like, but they're like more personal things.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he was not such a nice guy back in the day. He said and did some stuff. Like, people were...
Well, I don't know that he did some stuff.
He said a bunch of things online.
Like, oh, yeah, his Twitter shit that he apologized a bunch for and still got called out and
you're
fired
comedian.
For.
Comedian, yeah, he got fired and then he got rehired because they're like, well, you're a good director, so maybe you said some shitty stuff, but maybe we forgive you. I don't know. That whole thing was weird, though.
Yeah. I got all the feelings about that, including how his movies were all about like forgiveness and everything and him being grateful. And plus, they fucking hired him after he fucking publicly apologized for that stuff in the first place. And then this right-wing fucking white supremacist dude tries to take him out. Because
dug it all
was,
back up.
Yeah, well, because James Gunn was like super outspoken about politics and stuff before he got fired. And now he's back on social media and stuff, but he just posts pictures of his cats. Yeah, he's got cats. I like dogs. Cats are cool. I'm more dogs, though.
Mm.
You gonna get a cat?
I don't think so. I've thought about it a couple of times, but I don't think I will.
Yeah.
I mean, I do so much running around, you know, like I'm getting ready to go back to New
York.
That's
why you want a cat instead of a dog.
Yeah, but I can't leave a cat in the house for like 3 weeks when I go to New
York,
right?
Well, you get somebody to look at it.
Yeah, you gonna come look after my cat, Green?
We'll party.
Yeah, I know. And I'll come back to an empty apartment. You'll rob me while
I'm in. That's right. You just let me know. Just give me the key.
See, that's a problem.
All right. I mean, allegedly. Whatever. It'll be fine. The cat did it.
The cat sold all my shit. Well, cat also stolen in this hypothetical
that's
situation.
That's right. I took care of him, you know. I was like, oh, shit. This cat fucked up. He's fucking up with Matthew's shit. I got to take him out. Yeah. All right. Well, I did want to touch base, besides talking about these movies, which I am excited for. Actually, we can't get on a tangent and don't finish it. So I'm actually excited for the new Suicide Squad movie because James Gunn's involved with it. And but as far as like anything else, there's going to be a bunch of Marvel shit happening. I know that Disney Plus is out and they got the fucking Mandalorian show on there.
I haven't seen it yet.
I haven't either because they don't even have Disney Plus here in Germany yet. I think it comes out next month.
Oh, yeah?
Or in March or something.
I've heard mixed reviews about the show itself.
And oh, really?
And basically nobody can really talk about anything other than this, like, the asset. A.K.A. the child.
Oh, yeah. A.K.A. Baby Yoda,
which
whatever.
Which it's not, right?
Oh,
like,
it's not?
Like, Jon Favreau is super pissed off about people calling it Baby Yoda.
Oh, yeah.
Because it's not a Baby Yoda. It's not Yoda.
Right.
Therefore, not Baby Yoda.
Right.
Like, Yoda exists as its own thing.
I was going to say, it's like, isn't there a line in, like, Jedi where he's like 900 years old or 600 years old or something.
But that's
so
not
I'm
even
like,
the
damn,
point.
They was... really fucking went way back for this fucking show to happen.
Well, but Yoda was old when you go all the way back to like episode one. He was already hundreds
that's
of years
true.
Old. And so I think The Mandalorian actually takes place after the middle trilogy. Is that right?
I have no idea.
I can't remember.
Well, yeah, if there's a specific time that... Well, I'm sure they always have like a specific timeline that it takes place in, or a
right.
specific point in time in,
right.
in the timeline.
Yeah.
Yeah. That makes sense.
Time. So Yoda already exists out in the world.
Yeah.
And this is just same species.
Right.
Of creature
it sounds
as
racist.
Yoda.
People are just fucking racist.
Yeah, it's like saying like all, I don't even know what Yoda's species name it is.
Let's compare it to something in real life and not try to sound racist ourselves. Oh, yeah. You could do a lot of things with that that we'll probably Google. Not do.
Okay, oh, yeah? Google.
Are you going to Google it?
Okay, Google.
Yeah.
What species is Yoda?
Okay, I'll wait.
What? I'll wait. What? No.
That's not what you want.
What species is Yoda?
Here you go.
Man, just tell me. Like, this is my problem with the Google thing. I feel like when I ask a question like that, they should just tell you.
They don't have an answer.
Oh, shit.
This is the Jedi Master Yoda was the best known member of a species whose true name is not recorded.
Oh, shit.
Known in some sources simply as Yoda's species.
That can't be true.
That's what
There's
it says.
No way.
That's what it says.
There's got to be like a fucking novel or something where they name him.
That's from Wikipedia.
Oh, shit. It's Wikipedia? It's probably true then. I believe it if it says that in Wikipedia.
Yeah.
I mean, the name.
Wikipedia.
That's got to be like the thing. So, I guess we'll never know.
You want to know what Jabba the Hutt's species is called? I can tell you that.
I think I heard that one before.
He's a Bomar.
Oh no, I never heard of that before.
Yeah, right.
I was wrong.
I don't know.
Yeah.
Anyway. Unanswerable question, I guess.
Shit. Well, maybe one day we'll find out. I forgot that Jon Favreau was doing The Mandalorian. That gives me hope for that too then. And I haven't heard no bad shit about it. I've heard everybody saying it's great.
I heard that it gets into like just trying to do a lot of fan service later in the series.
Oh, well, that's fine.
Like they try and cram in a lot of references to other stuff and like.
Yeah, of course they do. Like what else are you going to do now?
Because nostalgia is a thing that exists.
Yeah, right? Fucking Stranger Things. How about that show? But I am excited about. Oh, yeah. I still haven't seen the new episode of. The other Star Wars thing that's happening, the episode 9, is it? Yeah.
Oh, I haven't either. The last of the new movies.
Yeah.
The Rian Johnson films.
That's right. Rian Johnson?
Is it Rian Johnson?
I got no fucking clue. Is that the director? I thought they had different directors
for
each one.
J.J. Abrams and then like.
And then this other guy took over.
Yeah, and then
because they realized J.J. Abrams can't make a movie that's not a reboot. J.J.
Abrams came back and then screwed everything. I think that's what it was.
Yeah.
I think he did the first one and the third one, and then the middle one was somebody else.
Yeah, that sounds good to me.
Oh, yeah, because people are all upset about him, about what he did with, like, the character arcs.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Huh.
Because he, like, you know, when they did the second one,
the Last Jedi, right? Yeah.
When they did The Last Jedi, and that was Rain Wilson, what's the guy's name?
Ray? Oh, I don't know.
What's his name?
Green. I got no fucking clue.
Damn it, Green.
This is supposed to know this. Actor's name?
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't know the actors' names. I don't know the characters' names.
Episode.
I like to believe that the characters are real and actors are bullshit.
Is it The Last Jedi? Yeah. The director. Yeah. Rian Johnson.
Rian Johnson. That's the most like that's one of the most average names I've ever heard.
Right, but he did so he did like a bunch of bold things, right?
Okay.
He's got to because his name's so average. Because like, he said that like Rey, I don't know, spoiler alerts if you haven't seen the second new trilogy or whatever, but you're not special, like you're nobody's kid. You just happen to have the Force because you happen to be Force tuned, but you're not like a Skywalker.
Oh, yeah.
And it's like, you're just some average girl, right? And like people thought that was a new bold way. And now J.J. Abrams is back. And so he like changed it back up again.
Oh, really?
Big spoiler alert. He's like,
I'm going to make it go this way. And then he comes in and he's like, I'm going to make it go this way.
Yeah,
and they're like, fuck
undid,
you.
Kind of undid yeah. all the things from the all second right. one.
Well, I'll be stoked to see that because it was the whole thing where I was like, man, I don't know about these new Star Wars movies. Didn't really like episode 8 that much. Not even for the reasons that like all the big, I don't know, people on the internet was saying where they were like, I don't know. What were some of the fucking things people would say?
A lot of it was sexist bullshit where people were just like not liking it because they put like powerful women in.
Oh, yeah. And I fucking loved that. Like,
me too. Come on.
Yeah.
I want more powerful women in the world.
I thought all the characters were pretty good. I wasn't a big fan of like Luke dying right away because I was like, I want to see fucking. Oh, yeah. Spoiler alert. Shit. I guess I was supposed to say that earlier. Maybe for the description on this, I should just say, hey, we talk about a shit ton of movies.
Spoiler alert
galore.
There's something, right. I was reading something the other day that was talking about like people are mad, right? Because like after things got fucked up, right? Like,
what got fucked up? Like what Luke, are we talking about now? Oh, yeah.
Like Luke is off hiding, right?
Yeah.
Like all by himself on some
deserted island. Oh, and he's such an asshole. Deserted he fucking island? Burns the books and shit. And is like, what are you, a fucking Nazi or something?
No, but the whole thing, like he fucked up real bad, right? Like he was training a bunch of Jedi.
Yeah.
And then like Ben Solo, he like fucked up and he kind of went to the dark side and he couldn't stop him and he becomes like a little bit of a bad guy, right?
Yeah.
And so as a result, instead of trying to fix it,
like he's Luke like pieces oh, fuck out everything. Right?
He's like, fuck off, I'm gonna go hide. And he like disappears and doesn't tell anybody where he's going. He just fucking fucks off.
Yeah.
But goes into hiding. And everybody's like, oh, way to be a role model, right? But if you think about it, right, let's go back. Who was Luke's teacher?
Right.
Right? Obi-Wan Kenobi?
Well, who did the same
after
thing.
After everything got fucked up, he went and hid on a desert island, became like a desert hobo.
Yeah. Well, he desert planet. Yeah, but he was staying close to Luke.
Yeah. But then like take it back further, who was Obi-Wan Kenobi's teacher?
Yoda, who
and it was Yoda. And
eventually did the same
and Yoda
thing.
Yoda went to Dagobah and held out on that swamp planet all by himself.
That's
after
right.
Shit got all fucked up, and he was like, "Yeah, I'm just leave me alone. Don't come find me."
Yeah, like, but that was kind
of
like
Jedi have a history of fucking shit up and then running away from their problems instead of facing.
it that's kind of true. I do agree with that. I wish that you know I don't know, and it's the whole thing where like now that you've killed me, I'll be even stronger. Because I can like make my force body appear, but I'm like
blue ghost.
I don't know. I think you were doing better. I mean, you definitely fucked more shit up while you were alive. So that to me makes a case that you were more powerful before you died. So yeah, I don't know if I agree with all the bullshit in the Star Wars universe, but yeah, would I still like to live in that universe? Fuck yeah.
No. A war-torn universe with low-tech meeting high-tech? I would not like that. They don't have air conditioning. They got laser blasters and like...
Yeah, that shit's cool.
Plasma swords.
I seen a movie.
But no fucking looks air good. Conditioner.
But they can travel through space real easy.
Not real easy, though.
Easier than I can.
Yeah, well, that's true.
Yeah.
Isn't it a weird thing, like a weird juxtaposition of high technology and low technology? Like, you got a hovercraft.
Right.
But you gotta like hand fix your robots and stuff. I don't know. There's weird things that don't match up and all that.
Yeah, that's definitely true. Well, actually, I had this discussion with somebody. I don't remember who the fuck it was.
Or even just like fighting with a sword, right?
Uh-huh.
Because it's a laser sword, sure.
Yeah.
But you have a spaceship.
But you only really get one if you're a Jedi.
Well, that's not true. That robot had like four of them.
Oh, that's true because you killed all the Jedis.
Cyborg, I guess.
Yeah. Well, that's the thing too. But there's a chance you could end up with the Force, and that'd be cool, especially if you went to the dark side. Yeah, I mean that would not be cool to go to the dark side. You got to be a Jedi, right?
I don't know.
Seems like either way, you're
the dark side. Yeah, but the
up.
Dark side gets like lightning power. You never see a Jedi
that's
shooting
right.
lightning out of their
well,
fingers.
Well, because that's like the easy way to just inflict pain on people.
Okay. I'm with you. Anyway.
Yeah, I don't know. I think it could be cool. I mean, there's plenty of war-torn shit going on in this universe, so who knows what's going to happen in 2020. Maybe this is like, he says it's happening far, far away, long time ago, whatever, and it's actually like, oh, I was just kidding. We're leading into it. Suddenly everybody's flying to the moon, and... I don't know, Donald Trump's fucking shooting lightning bolts out of his fingertips.
Oh, he would totally be a Sith, yeah.
I know, he kind of looks like the Emperor, just like way fatter.
He does, kind of.
And I mean, if he wasn't fake tanning all the time, he would probably have the same kind of complexion.
Emperor Plumpentan.
Yeah, that's right. With Darth Plumpentan. Darth Trump. Fucking piece of shit. Anyway, yeah, that's real controversial what I just said there. I'm sure I'm going to lose a lot of fans.
No, but, I don't think so.
I keep wanting to fucking... I could just fucking rant about movies all day.
I know, We were talking about... Well, we were talking about technology. We were talking about getting you some new technology.
That's right. Were we talking about that? I definitely want to talk about that. Yeah. So I got this fucked up podcast, and now I want to make sure... That's my New Year's resolution that I will talk about here. I got a few more we could talk about later.
Yeah.
But no more shitty-sounding podcasts. That's my promise. And it might mean that I miss a fucking week, but I'm still going to come out with like two a month at the minimum. And hopefully more than that. We'll see. I hope I get some more people calling into the Intruder Green call-in line, because that's always fun. And yeah. And I believe, since we talked about it earlier, but I'm going to start coming on the Shot at That podcast more often.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. If you want to tell your fans what's going on there.
Everybody, well, I think I just did.
Tuning in, listen. Well, I mean, you want to explain a little bit better?
Yeah. Well, you know, if anybody doesn't know, Matthew's got a podcast called I'll Take a Shot at That. We did a little crossover action a while back. And I've been on the podcast in the past. And, you know.
You've been on as a guest before.
Yeah, that's right.
And then we did a couple of podcasts that we did together because I went on tour with Masked Intruder this summer.
That's right.
And so we did some shared experience podcasts.
Yeah.
And as part of what's going on in 2020, you're going to become like an official co-host.
Yeah.
Like a full-time, part-time.
Yeah, full-time, part-time.
A full-time, part-time co-host of the show. And beyond, I'll take a shot at that a lot more, right?
That's right.
Cool.
Because I love reaching out to the fans and, you know, doing some other weird shit because, like, well, what... I'll Take a Shot at That has kind of like a different format than this thing that I do.
Yeah, I think a little bit. Like with I'll Take a Shot at That, it's very much a personal diary thing, but then it's also like I'm out trying to figure out what living in Germany is like, what living in Leipzig is like, and trying to like experience the things that are culturally going on here.
Yeah, so and I like a lot culture
of,
and
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, there's a lot of opportunity for us to go and do things and then get back on the show and talk about what we've done. Which, by the way, did you see the post? Did you see that there's like a whiskey festival in Trebsen this weekend?
Oh, shit. Well, I'm going to miss that.
Yeah, no, I'm really disappointed. Oh, it's my birthday weekend, too.
Also, yeah, it is your birthday. Happy birthday.
Thank you. Thank you, Green.
Yeah, of course.
I appreciate that.
I'm also not drinking this month because of multiple things. Fucking cops and, you know, just my body a break. I got to get ready, though.
How did you fail a piss test for alcohol? Like, how much alcohol did you have in your system that you failed that piss
test? Yeah, I don't think... It's weird that they were testing me for alcohol with my piss in the first place.
Right.
But, yeah, maybe they were just testing me for weed, but then nothing came out but actual booze when I peed.
Pee and beer.
Yeah. Or it could be that I just...
Or White Claw, right?
Yeah.
That's your new thing.
Delicious White Claw. You can't get that in Europe yet, though.
Yeah, you can.
I haven't seen it.
Maybe not the White Claw brand, but you can definitely get alcoholic soda water. Oh, man,
there's a lot of shitty brands out there, though. There's the White Claw. They do something special. It's probably like extra bad cancer-causing shit in there. But,
Bisphenol
A. I tried the... When we were on tour, I think, one day we got this fucking
PBR
seltzer shit, and that was disgusting.
What?
It tasted like chalk.
What?
It was fucked up.
Why doesn't White Claw send you like Green Claw?
That's a good question, White Claw. Anybody know why White Claw isn't giving me the lime flavor. That stuff is delicious. My favorite is probably the black cherry, but I'll drink any kind of White Claw they give me.
Green
to be
Claw
honest.
For the Intruder Green podcast.
Green Claw, baby. All right. Yeah,
or
honestly,
send us some White Claw. We'll drink it on. I'll take a shot at that.
Yeah, you know, you need to branch into the European markets with the White Claw. So send it on over, and we'll drink it on down.
Yeah,
yeah, that's a good slogan.
So we're definitely gonna start having you around for episodes of I'll Take a Shot at That.
Yeah, it's gonna be fun.
And as part of that, we're doing this other thing. This whole nice one.
Oh yeah, the twitching.
We're gonna do some twitching.
Yeah,
some live streaming. Which honestly, we probably should be live streaming what we're doing right now.
Yeah, that could be a thing.
These conversations like this.
It's true. I don't know if that. It's interesting to see, find out what people find entertaining these days. Watching a couple dudes hang out in a studio with microphones in their face talking to each other. You would think they just want to hear it, but maybe some people do want to see it. I don't know. It
works for Joe Rogan, man.
Yeah. Fuck a Joe Rogan.
And I don't know, some other basement dwellers.
Yeah, there's, you know, I remember like there was a radio show that I used to listen to pretty regularly, and it was just like people talking.
Yeah, I don't really.
But they would.
Yeah.
They would stream video of that too, and it was like just them in a radio studio, and I was like, huh, I guess people watch this. And then they'd go off air, and then they'd be doing like the fucking recording the little ads and stuff they do.
Mm-hmm.
And it's funny because you get to see them screw up and shit.
Right. That could be fun.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess the thing is if we did this live, yeah, like if we were doing this live, and people could like chat into us, right?
Oh yeah, that's true.
So because that's the big cool thing about when we're doing the video game thing on Twitch.
Yeah.
For Shot at That, which by the way, anybody who wants to check that stuff out, it's twitch.tv/wellroundedhoodlum. And you can follow the channel right now. You can't subscribe yet because we need like 50 followers before it actually allows us to do that stuff.
Right. Do you want to spell that out? For anybody who might not know what you said.
Well-rounded hoodlum. So it's just all one word, WellRounded Hoodlum.
I believe it to be true.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Twitch.tv. Or just, we'll get the links up, yeah. I think.
Oh, yeah. There'll be
the
links.
The videos are going on your YouTube channel,
attached,
right?
Attached to this thing. Yeah, exactly. You can get on the Intruder Green YouTube channel, and they'll be on there. I thought about putting it on the Instagram TV, but I don't know, fuck that.
What about the it's Patreon? Too complicated. You can put it on Patreon too, right?
That might be the thing to do.
You should definitely link to it on their Patreon. Put a post up with the videos. Maybe don't make people pay for it on Patreon because they can get it for free on YouTube.
Right.
But at least patreon.com/intrudergreen is an easy way to access it.
Yeah, yeah.
And then while they're there, if they want to give you some money, they can do that.
That's right.
You know? Open up the wallet.
Give me all the money. All right. I mean, I'm going to get it somehow, so
I'm super happy, by the way, about this, about doing this crossover interview, because I am going to New York next week.
Oh, that's right.
And talking with you is helping me brush up on my accent.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
So I'm not going to feel like I've
been
gone.
Wait, are you going to prison?
No, I'm just New York.
Oh, well, it's a prison accent. I don't know about New York.
I know yours is a prison accent, but it's helping me get my New York accent back up to shape.
All right. that works for me. That's good. I like it. Thanks for listening to the Intruder Green Podcast. By now, you probably heard about our sponsor, Stupid Rad Merch Company. And if you haven't, then listen up, because I got to tell you, Stupid Rad Merch Company is a great web store with a bunch of your favorite bands at StupidRadMerch.com. And if you're in a band and need some work done, they can get you totally covered for a modest price and super quick turnaround time. But don't just take it from me. Here's what the ladies from Bad Cop, Bad Cop had to say about it.
Yeah, you come up with great ideas. It's always pushing, always moving. Simeon is delightful to work with. He's very responsive and professional. And
it's the quality of the shirts. I like
them. Yeah, high quality.
Very well done. Very well done on the ink.
It really feels like a family again. Yeah. It feels like it's a place where you can trust what's happening.
And don't forget to use the code PRISON at checkout and get a 15% discount on all Stupid Rad branded apparel. That's PRISON, I think. I don't really know how to spell, but those are the letters they told me to say. StupidRadMerch.com.
StupidRadMerch.com.
Guitar players, I bet you thought you were shit out of luck when it comes to finding your dream guitar or amp. You know, you go on some auction site or something, and it's all crap? Well, that's because you're not looking in the right place. Yeah Man's Vintage and Used Guitars is exactly what you're looking for. Now, I know what you're thinking. Aren't they located in Switzerland? Yeah, man, they are. Bern, Switzerland, to be exact. But you can check out all the super tight finds at Yeah Man Guitars on their website. YeahManGuitars.com. Eh, it's right. If you got something specific you're looking for, and maybe you need some help finding it, you just hit up Yeah Man's Guitars on the electronic mail. Yeah, you email them.
That's right. It's the 21st century, and we got emails and stuff. YamasGuitars@gmail.com is where you go for that. And then while you're at it, why don't you get your band a tour in Europe? You can stop by the shop. Sure, Michael and the rest of the crew would love to meet you, and you could tell them Green sent you. Yeah, man's vintage and used guitars.
Yeah, so no more shitty quality fucking shit for the fans, because you guys are good, and especially like the producers on Patreon who actually like help me, you know, fund the show. I want to make sure I'm giving them a good quality product, and I want to try to get like 3 or 4 episodes a month. Like, I want to try to do it once a week, but you know, the hardest part is getting guests to fucking do it.
Yeah, certainly.
Like, I got a lot of people saying they want to do it, but then it's hard to fucking line the timing up and everything. So, you know, that's like kind of the hardest part about it, really. And then you get them on there finally and you talk and it's like, oh shit, it's been an hour. Can't we keep going?
Yeah, talking's easy, right?
Yeah, exactly. But anyway, trying to do more, trying to do that. I got more content I want to work on this year.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. Well, like we got that cooking show in the works. And I've talked about that before, so it's not like a big reveal. I don't know. It's been sitting there. We gotta finish that up.
Are we gonna do that ever?
Yeah, we do need to do that ever. And I want to do some dance videos, too.
Yeah, you were telling me you had this this girl that you really enjoyed that was going to teach you how to dance. She was on a podcast,
Araneva.
Yeah.
And she does all sorts of shit. Like, she's basically, like, she makes a living out of dancing. Like, she does videos on, like, I don't know what she does, like, YouTube and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And then she actually does instructional classes,
yeah,
like, in person, and like goes to different cities and does them and stuff. So that's good for her. I think she does some burlesque stuff too, which is kind of cool. And that's like the premium stuff. And yeah, I don't know. She's kind of inspired me because I like to dance, as you know, or anybody knows if they ever seen Masked Intruder play live.
Certainly.
Yeah. So I need to do more of that. And the real problem with the dancing thing, it's partially like figuring out a way to do it where you got music, but it's not, you know, going to get you in trouble and get your fucking shit taken off because of the copyright bullshit.
Right.
Which I guess the way to do that is to not have it like...
And just make your own music. If only you knew some musicians.
If only that was... Yeah, right. Well, yeah.
Yeah, right.
Doing it every fucking week is going to be the thing.
That's hard.
Yeah.
Or people give you permission to use their music.
That's also a thing. But I feel like,
and
I don't know.
And you just do interpretive
like
dancing
the
to their songs?
Being the way it is, it's like fucking Mark Zuckerberg's going to go on there and just take it down anyway.
Yeah, they get you.
Yeah.
Hmm.
So anyway, but I guess the way to do it is to just have it live in the room and then people fucking don't notice it or something, or the computers don't notice it and automatically take it down. It's like if somebody comes after me and says,
I don't think that's how that works.
Well, that's how Araneva does it, so
okay,
I'm gonna shoot for it.
Well, she probably doesn't use popular music, does she?
Oh no, but I'm not going to either. It's punk rock, baby. All right.
Yeah, okay.
Actually, punk rock's not that easy to dance to. It's more fun to just like jump around and push people to. But I do like to dance to some other stuff. So, yeah, I might have to, you know, dig deep, as the kids like to say, and find some interesting dance tunes that, you know, I like all sorts of weird shit. So, maybe you'll see Intruder Green dancing to some stuff that's not exactly punk rock. And maybe you'll fucking lighten, what do you call it, brighten your horizons or some shit.
Broaden your horizons,
that's the one.
Sure.
Yeah. Not you specifically, Matthew, I'm talking about the people listening,
of
you
course
know?
Right, right.
Yeah. I know you got all sorts of crazy tastes in music and
I have very
all sorts
broad
of
horizons.
Culture and shit. Yeah, that's right.
What else are you going to be working on in the coming year?
All right.
There was some talk that you and I had for a while about some educational videos as well, right? Like, I know we talked about the cooking thing, but we were like, you're learning to speak German.
Oh yeah, I got to learn how to speak German if I'm going to keep living over here. Yeah. That's right. What the fuck did we talk about?
We had a couple of ideas that where you could teach people how to speak a little bit of German.
That's true. We could do that. That might only be one video, though, because I don't know German too good.
Yeah. Well, I mean, but as you learn more German, maybe it means more videos.
That's true. Could be.
Can you give us a sample of your lessons?
Oh, man.
Uh-huh. Like, I think you taught me a quick and easy way for saying thank you.
Oh, yeah.
If you don't know how to say thank you in German, you taught me how to cheat at it, right?
Yeah, that's right. Fuck, what was it, though? I don't remember it no more.
I think it was, you just say thanks to Shane, right?
Oh, yeah. Thank you, Shane. I can't take all the credit, though, for that. I think Blue came up with that.
Yeah.
I learned more from being on tour in Europe than I did it actually taking German lessons. Oh, shit. Or maybe you came up with that.
It was one of the jokes from the tour.
Yeah, that's right.
Just say thanks to Shane. Thank you, Shane.
That actually happens a lot on tour where somebody comes up with a joke and, you know, eventually everybody's doing it and nobody remembers who created it in the first place.
Yeah, I remember there was almost a... Oh, I just had a flashback. I'm sorry. Yeah. I remember there was like a downright argument over
the
origin of a joke.
Yeah, I'm not surprised.
It got intense when we were in Vienna. I don't know if you remember the non-issue.
It was
dinner that night. That was almost a downright fist fight over who came up with that joke.
Yeah, the fucking shit people worry about when they're on tour. Then you get back home and you're like, oh, shit. Yeah, I guess we really are just friends. We should probably just keep getting along and not worry about, you know, all that stupid bullshit.
About who didn't get a piece of naan.
Yeah.
That was good times, though.
Oh, good very times. Good times. Very good times. Yeah, what else, though? Maybe like instructional videos I could do. We got these amplifiers from Marshall that we'd like to do like some kind of like a instructional video on because I could play guitar real good. What are you drinking?
Well, Shot I was drinking a beer.
Drinking podcast, so you're drinking a beer. What?
I had an Krustitzer, but yeah. It's gone now.
Oh shit! Do you need another one?
I need one? A new one.
Oh shit!
Should I take a break and go refill my drink?
Yeah, we could hit pause for that.
All right.
Or I'll talk about this one.
You talk about that one. I'm going to go get a drink. You need something?
No, I'm going to keep drinking this thing.
Should we do a shot?
I can't do a shot. I'm not drinking right now.
Should I do a shot?
Fucking parole officers and shit.
I'll do a shot.
All right. Do a shot. I'm going to talk about what I'm drinking.
Yeah.
It's not alcoholic, but it is full of fucking caffeine and sugar. And it's so weird because like they got that fucking stuff. What the hell is it called? Club Mate. Is what I call it, but I think the Germans call it Club Mata, even though it ends with an E, and they go for that sound, but it's not a U or an A, it's an E. So it's kind of weird to me because it looks like Club Mate, like let's go to the club, mate, like you're Australian or some shit, but they're German, so whatever, it don't make no sense, and that's fine, but let's see, I'm drinking this stuff called Mio Mio. And it's pretty good. It's another like, I don't know. What is that? Like Urban Mate. And it gives you tons of energy. Got tons of caffeine in it. And I'm drinking a caffeine because I can't drink no booze. Which is, I don't know. I don't know which is better.
You up on that Mata?
I'm up on that Mata. But this is like the...
Oh, the Mio Mio Mata?
Yeah, well...
It's a good one.
They do one that's like banana flavored.
They do one that's ginger flavored too. That's real fucking good.
That would be good. That makes sense. Like ginger and the Club Mate, because the Club Mate, I don't even know how to fucking describe the flavor of that shit.
Club Mata?
Like, yeah.
Well, it's Mata.
Yeah.
So like Erba Mata, like okay. The tea.
So what does that taste like?
It tastes like Erba Mata. It tastes like the ground.
Exactly.
A little bit like the
how
dirt.
How do you describe it without just saying it tastes like what it is?
Right. Well, I mean, people know what. Yerba Mate.
I don't know what that tastes like.
They've been drinking Yerba Mate, and I don't know. It's like Yerba Mata or Yerba Mate.
This is a podcast for punk rock. It's not hippies.
Well, yeah, but they've been drinking Yerba Mate in Southern California. I mean, hippies can listen too, but the 80s.
Motherfuckers are broke, so.
It's a tea.
They ain't giving me no money.
Come on, it's an herbal tea.
Okay, so it tastes like tea.
No.
But it's like carbonated tea.
Well, the Club Mata one is like, it's club soda. So it's carbonated.
Oh, yeah.
I always thought that.
But this
that
is carbonated.
It tastes a little bit like ginger ale. Like Club Mata.
Yeah, I can see
classic
that.
Classic Club Mata tastes a little bit like ginger ale.
But this is also carbonated.
I discovered Club Mata here in Europe on tour. Yeah. And it's like a lifesaver if you're traveling
Oh,
around.
Yeah, it's great, especially like what it does for you.
Hangover cure.
It gives you like the boost that like a Red Bull or some kind of regular energy drink, but it just fucking lasts forever.
Yeah, and it's less intense. There's no crash from it.
That's true. It's great. Club I Mata's love that stuff.
Shit.
Especially when we were in Nuremberg. We probably talked about this before because we did that whole recap stuff.
Mm.
But that was great when we did, you go up there and you like drink some of your fucking Club Mata down. And then you're like, all right, now fill it up with gin.
Vodka or gin?
Oh, gin is the way to go because it's all herbal. And they mix the flavors together and it's just like blobbity blobbity blue.
I'm going to do my shot.
Oh, yeah, cheers. What are you doing a shot of?
Just the limoncello. I made limoncello.
You gotta give me a recipe. I wanna try to do that.
I will do it. Maybe we can do it together for the cooking show.
Yeah, we should do that for the cooking show.
It's super easy, man.
I would cheers you, but that would be sacrilege, and I don't want Tom McGeehan to get worried.
Oh, right, because you can't cheers with. Yeah.
Yeah.
Don't do that. Hey, what's up, Tom?
Yeah, if Tom's listening.
Big shout out. I love you, Tom. I'm gonna drink this homemade limoncello that I made, though, because it's delicious.
Yeah, it is delicious. I tried some before it was January, and it's real good stuff.
Mm.
Limoncello in general is pretty tasty, you know.
It's not gotten super so alcoholic. Much better too.
Yeah, well, I smelled your stuff, your limoncello, not your stuff, but I smelled it earlier and it was like, holy shit, that smells like booze.
Yeah, as it settles in, it's gotten real nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's good stuff.
That's good. Because that's like my whole problem with like aperitifs or like whatever you got is like, yeah, they're delicious, but lots of times there's like very little booze in them. And I'm like, yeah, if I'm fucking drinking this to have a good time, then I'm going to have to drink a lot.
Yeah.
And it's going to be more sugar than booze. So then that's a bummer.
Yeah.
But yeah, Mio Mio, it's the guarana pomegranate flavor. And that's kind of weird. I don't know. I just bought it because it was like not the straight up.
Yeah, you got to get the ingwer, the ginger one.
That does sound good. I like the banana one, too. I love bananas.
Yeah?
Bananas. All right. Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. We're getting to the end of this, but what are you looking forward to in 2020? You got anything?
I mean, just doing more
stuff. You don't want to just save for your own show.
I mean, my big thing is going to be to really work on my German this year.
I really
want to get my German language skills in the next year up to a level to where I can operate very well.
Yeah.
And yeah, just kind of, I mean, if I'm honest with myself right now, I'm kind of at my capacity. I'm managing in some form or another, I think it is 5 podcasts.
Holy crap.
That I'm working on in various ways. Including my own, including your own,
yeah.
In his way that I can support that.
Absolutely.
Plus the Brave New Weed podcast, the theater podcast, Break a Bat podcast. These are all things that I'm currently.
Oh, I didn't know about Break a Bat podcast.
Yeah, I'm the editor and offline producer for
Break
a Bat.
Is it about baseball?
Well, it's where baseball meets Broadway. So it's a member of the Broadway Podcast Network.
Interesting.
So anybody who's into Broadway theater, and if you're into baseball and Broadway theater, it'd definitely be worth checking out. Because they have baseball people on that are associated with Broadway. They have Broadway people on and they talk about baseball. It's a meeting of two worlds that you normally wouldn't think of as colliding with each other. But they do a good job of putting it all together.
Oh, sure.
Yeah,
sounds good.
So all that's going on. So I'm really focused on the podcasting stuff and trying to get that going. Plus, you know, my small media production business that I do for other people, keep that up and running.
Yeah.
And then I'm super excited that we're going to be doing some live streaming stuff and working on Twitch.
Absolutely.
And everything like that.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, as time allows, just like make some more music, do some more jamming. Maybe there's some Breakables rehearsals that take place this year. I don't know.
Oh, yeah.
Keep your eyes out for the Breakables.
That's right. Are you're doing Hoper with a buddy
doing
Sammy?
Doing Hoper, yeah. Playing in a band called Hoper.
Yeah.
Which is a project of our friend Sammy Stevens.
Yeah.
Many people know who he is from his own solo work, but was sort of playing some punk rock music. Yeah, he toured with
Joe McMahon.
Toured with Joe McMahon. That is correct.
That's right.
And yeah, you know, just that stuff that I'm taking it as it comes. You know, the music thing, I'm not pushing too hard. But at the same time, not letting it die because I am a musician at heart.
So oh, yeah.
Got to keep playing.
For sure.
But otherwise, a lot of this year, I think, is going to be self-work.
Oh, yeah.
Taking care of me, trying to get this whole, you know, in 2019 was my first full year of living in Europe.
Yeah, that's right. We both, well, yeah, it was my first year of doing this podcast because I started in January. So
yeah, mine started coming February. Coming up with the
anniversary of that, and you doing that too. But your first year, full year living in Europe.
My first year to live here. And yeah, I'm working really hard to be more kind to myself in this next year.
Oh yeah, that's good.
I'm a really harsh self-critic, right? Like I always want things to be as best as they can be, or I want to do more than I'm doing, or I want to do bigger things, or I want them to be more popular.
Yeah.
And a big goal for me in this coming year is going to be to like just, you know, be a little bit nicer to myself, be a little bit cooler about being forgiving about my expectations of things, I think.
Yeah.
So I'm going to try and look inward in this year.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's important. I'm probably a little too good to myself because I'm like, hey, let's see what happens here. Is it going to work? Mm. I don't know. Let's go for it anyway.
Not really being worried about it. Yeah, I mean, like, it's you know, the whole 2020 thing. It's like hindsight is always 2020.
Yeah, that's right.
So maybe looking back at how I've been in my life and maybe making some adjustments or having that 2020 vision.
Yeah.
All of these are hashtags that you can send me 10% for if you want to steal 2020 vision or hindsight is always 2020 or double critical successes. For those of you that are my role-playing friends out there in the world. Right. Because a nat 20.
I was wondering where you were going with that. I was like, I'm lost now.
I mean, when you roll a 20 on a 20-sided die, that's a critical success.
Okay.
And so 2020, that's double critical successes.
Ah, okay.
So hopefully this will be a double critical success year for everybody. Yeah. All my RPG folk out there.
Yeah, that's right.
My D&D nerds.
Maybe, yeah. So that reminds me of Twitch when we play games on a Twitch. Anyway, we should, wrap this up because it's time for you to go to the bar and do trivia.
We're going
to
go do some trivia tonight. Yeah.
And, yeah, everybody watch out for, me on the Shot at That or Well-Rounded Hoodlum channel on Twitch.
Twitch.tv/Well-Rounded Hoodlum.
Yeah. And I don't
we'll
know.
Put links on like Shot at That website. So shotatthat.com.
That's right.
S-H-O-T-A-T-T-H-A-T.
Yeah. And I'm going
to
be.
Or Take a Shot at That or I'll Take a Shot at That. They all go to the same place. It's funny how the internet works like that.
It is.
You go to shotatthat.com.
It's the hub.
Look for. That's the hub. Yeah.
Yeah.
You find everything else right from there. Bring back the .com.
That's right.
Abandon social media. Go back to the .com.
It's all social media.
We're going
to
do it.
All right.
Do we have time? You had asked me about a would you rather. Do we have time to do any would you rather?
Oh, shit. I don't know. Yeah, I guess so.
Or was there something else you wanted to talk about before we go?
No, I was just going to do those shout outs to fucking promote ourselves and just say that, like, you know, like, I'm trying to do more content in general, and I think you're probably going to be involved with some of that because you're Mr. Audio Video over here.
We're going
to
do it.
And yeah, so be on the lookout for that. I got a couple would you ratters, though.
Support the Patreons.
Oh, yeah.
Patreon.com/IntruderGreen.
Yeah, well, you got the Shot at That Patreon, too.
Patreon.com/Shot at That. That's fine.
Yeah. You got like a Well-Rounded Hoodlum one, too, just for regular
shit? No, it's all going to be the same. Like, yeah. Right, like the Well-Rounded, and I might look at changing the Well-Rounded Hoodlum Twitch channel to be Shot at That.
Oh, yeah.
Just so it's all easier, but right now it's set up Well-Rounded Hoodlum.
Sure.
Well-Rounded Hoodlum is my production company. Shot at That's the podcast, so.
Yeah, that makes sense, I think.
Yeah.
I won't think about it too hard, though.
Yeah, I wouldn't. I mean, basically, if you give one money, you give money to all, anyway. It's a big table that we all sit around.
Well, this question isn't as good as I thought it was going to be.
A 2020 would you rather.
But it kind of ties into what we were talking about earlier, so let's go for it. Would you rather be an unimportant character in the last movie you saw or an unimportant character in the last book you read?
Oh, Jesus.
Can you think about what those were?
Yes.
What movie did I just see?
Maybe.
Oh, I just saw that fucking Suburbicon movie.
You know, it's not a movie, but the last thing that I actually watched, not a movie, was the BBC Dracula.
Oh, God, I was going to say I watched that, too.
Did you see that?
I saw the first episode, and I was like, holy shit, this is terrible.
Oh, man. The second episode is better.
Oh, yeah.
And then the third episode is just like, what the fuck? The third episode just goes completely off the rails.
Well, that's kind of like what I was hoping for, though, after like I got halfway through the first episode and I was like, I don't even know if I want to keep watching this. And but like, then it gets so ridiculous that I'm like,
is I think it took them halfway through the first episode to find out that they're like actually quite funny.
Yeah.
Because I don't think they intended to be funny at the very beginning. I think they were trying to be a little bit serious.
Yeah.
And then they just realized that they're like a comedy show.
Is that how fucking showbiz works? They're like in the middle of filming this thing that they got this budget for the BBC.
I don't know, man.
And then they're like, oh, wait, no, it's not serious. It's a comedy.
But like, it's really funny. And if you watch it as a comedy, it's much more entertaining.
I kind of figured that out, too, because I was like, all right, to be honest, the last book I read, even though I don't know how to read, I just did it with like, it was like a picture book. It was Dracula.
Oh,
because I like vampires, Draculas and stuff, and Wolfmans and stuff like that, and creepy weird shit.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, well, this is like the classic fucking character, so I got to read the book. And so I got a nice picture book, and I fucking read it. And I was like, oh, shit. I seriously was like almost finished with the book, and then I was looking on the internet, and that fucking Dracula show was on. And I was like, well, I fucking gotta watch this now.
It's just silly.
But it's like they just fucking don't follow the actual storyline at all.
Oh no! But the ridiculousness of it, it just is great. There's I mean, like spoilers abound, but there's so much amazing moments that they put in there, like. I don't know. I don't know how much.
Spoiler alert!
Anyway, you watched it.
I watched the first episode. I might watch more now.
Baby,
that I'm thinking.
The baby.
Oh, what the fuck happened to baby?
The dead baby.
Oh yeah.
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 Amazing.
Yeah.
Amazingly
the funny thing
hilarious.
Too about it is it's so BBC.
Oh yeah.
Like with the special effects and I don't know what that look is, but it's like it has something to do with like the filters they use or something where it just
looks
like what on this end you're having this Dracula show and then like just down the street is fucking Downtown Alley or whatever that show is.
It really is like it's like the community theater of television somehow. It's just like
yeah. It's funny.
I think that was the last thing that I saw. Well, but coming back to the question of would I rather be one or the other, I think that I'm going to have to answer this as I would rather be a small character in the last film, because even if you're a bit character in a film, you get paid as an actor.
Oh, there you go.
Right?
Yeah.
So that's the way I'm going to interpret that.
Oh, the last film was Dracula.
So I would think it would be Dracula. If I go back.
What was the last book? What are you comparing this to?
The last book that I read was Peer Gynt.
I don't know what the fuck that is.
It's a play. It's like a Scandinavian origin play.
You could read Scandinavian?
It's in English.
Oh, all right.
I mean, translated into English.
Okay. That makes sense.
But that was the last book that I read.
Okay.
As far as fictional book goes.
Yeah.
And before that, the last book that I read was the script to another play called Jerusalem.
Oh.
And I won't say that I would like to be a minor character in that, because the English Theater of Leipzig is going to perform the play Jerusalem.
Oh shit!
In 2020,
and you're going to be a major character.
And I
want to
be a major character.
Hell yeah!
In that performance, specifically the lead, who is an incredible character, the character of Rooster in Jerusalem.
Excellent.
So I would not want to sign up and voluntarily be a bit part in that. I think I would like to be a bigger part in that.
Yeah.
But yeah, if it's just the question of, oh, a character in a book or a character in a movie,
yeah.
I don't think you get paid if you're a character in a book.
That's true.
I think if you act as a character, maybe that's not what the question means.
You just become a figment of the writer's imagination.
Maybe that's not what the question means, but that's how I'm going to interpret it.
Yeah. I interpret it as, do you want to be there when all the shit in the book happens, but you're not really part of it, but you're in the background? And for me, that's... between that Dracula book, not the show, but the book, the original Bram Stoker, and this movie I saw the other night, last night actually, called Suburbicon. You heard of this?
Suburbicon.
Yeah. Wow. I remembered seeing the previews when it came out, and it's like, it's fucked up. It's like this,
fucked up?
What's that?
Like Midsommar?
I didn't see that. It's okay. Definitely spoiler alert. Don't listen if you fucking are interested in seeing Suburbicon and not having
Shit.
Maybe we shouldn't talk about it then. Well, I'll tell you like what.
Is it any good?
I thought it was fucking great.
All right, then don't ruin it for me.
Okay. I won't ruin it for you, but I will like maybe sum up the trailer, cuz you could see the trailer and like not have it ruined.
Okay.
So it's basically like this 1950s suburb, and this black family moves in, and you know, it's all like this white community and this black family. So suddenly there's racial tension, and then a bunch of other fucked up shit happens, and that's all I can say.
Okay.
But that movie is so fucked up, and all the like people in the background are so like uncool and not okay. That I would rather be an extra in Dracula, or like a, you know, not important part in Dracula.
Okay.
Because then you could be like, you know, when it's all said and done, and you're like, oh shit, vampires are real. You'd just be like, oh wow, I'm glad I didn't get my fucking throat sucked blood out of, you know?
Maybe.
Yeah. Or maybe I could be like, shit, vampires are real? I want to be a vampire. And then I just like... go on a mission to go to fucking Romania and find some vampires to like
join up with. There are like no happy vampires in the history.
That's the way it seems.
Of vampirism.
Yeah.
They don't ever seem like they're having a good time.
Yeah. It seems more like a struggle. And it's like they get these powers, but ultimately it's like they also kind of get like, it's not easy. Like they can just get killed in their sleep anytime, you know?
Yeah.
Like I feel like Dracula, for as powerful as he was and evil and stuff, like he should have figured out a way to like guard himself maybe he's guarded when he's in his castle or some shit. I don't know.
I mean, you can definitely go out like a chump if you're a vampire. You can snuck up on and go out like a chump.
Spoiler alert, Dracula went out like a chump. All right. Thank you everybody for joining in with us this week. Me and Matthew Hendershot, we're going to go do some trivia and drinking and eating food and stuff. Pay attention to our Twitch channel and patreon.com/intrudergreen and patreon.com/shotatthat.
Yeah, shotatthat.com. That's all I ask.
Yeah,
just visit shotatthat.com.
Yeah. Get to me, you know, I'll do all the other stuff at the end too. All right. Bye, everybody.
Thanks, Green.
Yeah.
And that's it for the Intruder Green podcast. Thanks again to Matthew for being on it. We'll probably do some more stuff with him because he's always around, except for right now I think he's in New York or something doing some fancy photography shit or whatever. All right. You can hit me up on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram, all at Intruder Green. The Intruder Green calling line is +1-608-535-9608. Patreon.com/IntruderGreen if you want to become a producer. The Intruder Green Podcast is produced by Colin Bennett, hair and makeup by Genevieve Smith, set design by Dylan Raymer, catering by Matthew Hendershot, lighting by Squeak Lights, Rahway, New Jersey. Our theme song is Particles by Type Bros. Ciao, Bello.
All right.
And just like that, we got it. Whoop, whoa.